got a bass.
Nice little bass, huh?
Yeah.
Good.
Pretty good looking one.
You caught your first fish, huh, buddy? Mm-hmm. What do you think about that?
It's really cool. And the happy thing is I always wanted to catch a bass.
Where are you going, bub?
We're going on a tractor ride.
What'd you think?
Pretty fun.
Oh, we've had a nice time.
That's good, Russ. Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. We're doing some more brines over here. I wanted to fix this part for him.
That's called disking.
That is disking.
See what it does to the ground?
Yeah.
It cuts it like a knife. You remember when we went to the farm machinery show? The last thing we looked at was a drill. Well, this one is no different. If you look down at the bottom, you're going to see what looks like a gear. There's an adjustment on the front of the drill where I can make that gear be wider or skinnier. And if I want more seed, I make it wider. And if I want less seed, I make it skinnier. And that thing will be turning as I drive, and that's gonna put the seed in the ground. When the drill is up, I want the seed off. And I noticed on the way over here that the feed shaft was turning. And that's when I noticed that this part was broken. Now I could buy a new part, but that place is not open today. And it'd take me about half a day to drive over there and get it and come back, and that's if they've got it in stock. www.caseih.com, click on parts, and they've got every parts manual they've ever made on the internet now. So I click on International 620, or I type that in a search box, and it gave me several options, but one of them was International 620 drill, and I clicked on that, and then I clicked on main drive, and it gave me a schematic of how that goes together. Soybeans. $42 a bag.
One man smoke. Planting soybean, what do you do on Sundays?
One man smoke, trim tobacco. That's what my dad says. That's already five bags, right?
Six.
Oh, that's already
There's
six
There's a chart
bags.
Right here that tells us for 74 pounds per acre, we set the drill on number 20.
I think you're too close, bud.
And I've already done that. Want to even them out?
What?
Just move some over there where it's low. Yep. Looks good. This field was in soybeans last year. Brandon chisel plowed this field, and then I disc it twice, and then we had all that rain, and I just left it alone. And I came in here this morning with the Cultimulcher. Cultimulcher has a row of compactors, two ranks of cultivator teeth, and then another row of compactors. And because we had that little shower the night before last, these clods were a little bit soft. So when that compactor hit them, it busted the clods. So I just ran one pass with the Cultimulcher on all this land, and it's ready to go. So once they get, I don't know, anywhere from 6 inches tall to a foot tall, I can spray Roundup, the herbicide, and it will kill everything but my beans. So it doesn't really matter if I've got a few weeds left out here.
Mm-hmm.
Once the beans get up, I'll spray the Roundup and it'll zap all them.
So I got 2 acres.
I think there's 3 acres in this piece. But this is the tap root from that alfalfa plant, and this would have been the part that grows above ground. And there's some evidence out in the Midwest, some universities, they dug some of these up to see how deep they went. And in some of their fertile soil out there, they found alfalfa tap roots as deep as 15 feet. And That's the cool thing about the Roundup Ready soybeans. I don't need to apply any chemicals. I let them beans come up and get a good start and spray that Roundup most often one time and I'm good. That'll clean them up and the beans will be no weeds. Over here in the tobacco patch, on the other hand, we can't use Roundup. Roundup will kill the tobacco. So if I have weeds, we have to go after them mechanically with cultivators and hose. Now I did spray a herbicide on there, a pre-plant, pre-emergent herbicide that will prohibit new weeds from emerging. But any weeds that I didn't get out with my tillage, they'll probably go ahead and start growing. So we'll have to take those out either with the cultivator or with the hoe. But we've got a pretty good chemical weed control system now where we don't have to do a whole lot of that hoe action. When I was a kid, it was every day. And then Dad would come in the evening and climb on the tractor and cultivate to get rid of our footprints, so it would be pretty. You want to drill some beans? Mount up. I'm going to raise it up, drive across the waterway, and put it back down. And I want you to go across the back end of it real careful-like and see if there's beans falling at each one of those openers. With that sun behind me, I can't see them from the front. All I see is a glare. To myself, man, I hope he doesn't come back here and drive through Dad's wheat field. I want to stick to the roads. My dad will go off if you drive out in a standing crop. You probably understand that. Some people don't get that. Okie dokie, let's just dump one bag in each third of the hopper and keep doing that till we run out. Shake it all out. There you go.
Blue moon of Kentucky, keep on shining. Shine on the one it's gone and proved and true. Blue moon of Kentucky, on shining, shine on the one that's gone and left me blue. It was on a moonlight night, the stars shining bright, and they whispered from on high, your love has said goodbye. Blue moon of Kentucky, keep on shining. Said goodbye. Shine on the one that's gone and left me blue. It is on a moonlight night, the stars shining bright. They whispered from high, your love said goodbye. Blue moon of Kentucky, keep on shining. Shine on the one that's gone and said goodbye.